This is BCN.
Trivia Maniacs. Hello there, Ed Gardner and Dan and Patty. Welcome. Hey, look, I got fall leaves have changed. Welcome, everybody, to the show. Did you miss me? Oh, I missed you people. I'm glad I'm back in action here. Welcome to the show, everybody. Good evening, good afternoon, good morning, good night. That's the day. Thank you. It's over. The fastest hour on television. Thank you for coming in today. There will not be an Uncle Floyd show tonight. If you're looking to see Uncle Floyd tonight, he's canceled, had some scheduling differences. I don't know why I'm saying that. I got no interest in it. What am I going to say? But I hope you had a good weekend. I hear the Robert Hale thing was awesome. Wish I was there. Rich got some goodbyes. Dan got some goodbyes. And goodbye to everybody. There you go. And welcome. Welcome, Ed Gardner. How are you today? Good. Glad to hear it. We got some good features on the show today. We got some surprises. I don't know if they're surprises. It's the same old stuff. But we got some good crosswords or word puzzles, as I like to call them. So if you're ready, I'm ready. Hands on your buzzards. Remember, there's no wagering. We know all this stuff. What do I have to let the games begin, Gary says. Good. Terry Morgan won't be here today. Yeah, he said he'd be in tomorrow. But he's going to watch the reruns. That's just as good. So I'm glad you're here. Let's get on with the show. What's the first question? Here we go. All right, here's the first question. What was the only member of the WJM TV news crew not fired on the last episode of the Mary Tyler Moore Show? The only member of the news crew not fired on the last episode. You know, I don't sneeze all day, excuse me, until I come into the show. That's because this fan is right on my face. I got to move it. All right. Sorry I sneezed. I apologize. Every time I sneeze, an angel gets their wings. Right, stand back. I was social distancing. That's why I'm doing this show. Unbelievable. All right. Well, we're on the air again. I can't believe it. Facebook, Dickie Zuckerman. Is still letting us go. Good old Mike Zuckerdunk. Duckerman, that's what we call him. But let the games begin. Here we are. Are you on? I'm on. The only member of the WJM TV news crew that wasn't fired. Are we on? During the last episode of the Mary Tyler Moore Show. Did anybody watch it? Says I'm live. Oh, there you go. It's like more than a 90-second delay there. I think I know why. Because Facebook wasn't letting me see myself, and all of a sudden it was going crazy. All right? Tom Gentile, ladies and gentlemen. There he goes. Probably won a lot of money, magic tricks from Robert Hale. He had some big sales, I hear. Unbelievable. We got one answer. That's close enough. There you go. We got it? That's right. Ted Knight. Ted Knight or Ted Baxter. Ted Baxter. He was originally, worked in Albany, New York, I guess, at a TV station, too. That was exciting. Ted Knight. Ted Knight was the right answer. All right, well, maybe you're not big Mary Tyler Moore fans. I don't know. Hey, what gooey substance that bounced and stretched was sold in a plastic egg? What gooey substance that bounced and stretched was sold in a plastic egg? Maybe you'll come up with this one. Maybe this is your type of stuff. Gooey and stretchy substance that was packaged in an egg. All right. This is probably more your speed. Is anybody watching? It says I got 8 people. I've doubled my crowd. All right. Here we go. Rich Gilbert, ladies and gentlemen. There we go. All right, and Tom is here, and Gary Levinson, unbelievable. Who won last week? Jeffrey Allen, Terry, and Rich, and B.J. Hickman. And who? Pantyhose. No, it wasn't. All right, pantyhose. Stretchy was stretchy. I don't know if it was gooey or not, but yes, you're probably right. Pantyhose. It's crazy, isn't it? Unbelievable. What is going on here today? So I was looking forward to it. I worked all Saturday and Sunday coming up with new concentration and new bits and pieces and new crossword puzzles. Today, word puzzles has one from a member of our trivia crack staff. Rich sent me one. Let's see how you guys do with Rich's word puzzle. Got everybody. It was Silly Putty. Silly Putty. Where's Jonas? Is Jonas here? I didn't see him. He'll probably show up later anyway. There you go. That's a little bit of trivia. You know, our show today. Oh, I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Woo! I'll tell you why I'm happy. Because our show today is brought to you by MagicTricks.com. For the best magic tricks in the entire United States, it's MagicTricks.com. And they just signed on again. Hallelujah. They signed up. Oh, yes, indeed. Unbelievable. That's right. Mentalism with Silly Putty. Everybody yes. Likes Silly Putty. I'm so happy that because they signed up again. They just sent us some more magic codes, so we're good for the winter. And we have a great new product. You know, a lot of people say to me, Bob, is there a place where we can go to one place and get all sorts of chairs and couches in one location? Is there such a place? Well, friends, yes, there is. Now there is the Shack of Sit Furniture Showroom. Yes. You can sit in a shack and buy a shack of sit. It's that simple. So sit down and relax at the Shack of Sit. Whew. I got through it. Whew. That was pretty city. The Shack of Sit. Practice that a few times. Dan? Did Dan send me a word puzzle? I don't know. I don't know if I got it. Sometimes stuff goes and I don't see it. Hard to say. Yeah, it was hard to say. You try it, the Shack of Sit. Hey, what U.S. state entered into the Union the 14th of February, 1912? Was it Hawaii, Alaska, Washington, or Arizona? Hawaii, Alaska, Washington, or Arizona entered the Union on the 14th day of February, 1912. See if you can come up with something. All right? The fastest hour on TV. I just cracked up Patty. You try it, Patty. Say it with me. Shack of Sit. What is it? Oh, Gary. Gary. And I got some new magic minutes from my friend Jeffrey Allen. Ah, oh, things are cooking this week. Is Mrs. Cavendish coming in? Not today. She called me, says she's exhausted from that trip. All right? So, she's telling me she might stop in this week sometime. She doesn't want to wear out her welcome, she says. And Gardner, there we go. I miss Jonas. I don't know where he is, but he should be around somewhere, but I don't know where he is. But hey, will he show up on the show? I hope so. It's Arizona. It was the 48th state. 48th state was Arizona. In February, this is all about February, the month of February. Last time I did January, moved it up to February. In the February of 1959, whose plane crashed? Was it Glenn Miller, Carol Lombard, Buddy Holly, or Rocky Marciano? Plane crash. Glenn Miller, Carol Lombard, Buddy Holly, or Rocky Marciano? February of 1959. All right. Bum, bum. All right. Have a good time with us, folks. Thanks for coming in. We appreciate it. I don't know where this scenery came from the back, but I liked it. I found it on the internet, and I said, I love this. It's beautiful, beautiful. All right. What do I got here? Uh-oh, Robert Hale. All right. Send me everything else that you didn't sell, Robert. We'll sell it on eBay for you. Books, DVDs, we don't care. What do you got here? Oh, Rich, Robert Hale, Dan, and Patty. I'm going to give them an extra point just because Patty laughed at me. Or with me, right? With me, yeah. Buddy Holy, who, what? Tom Gentile, there you go. All right, what else we got? Ed Gardner? Good. Yeah, Gary Levinson. Yeah, that's the three. And Michael Mirth, there you go. It was. It was the day the music died. Buddy Holly on a plane with Richie Valens and J.P. Richardson, a.k.a. the Big Bopper. That was it. All right, there you go. So that was 1959, February of 1959. Who won the first Medal of Honor for their actions on the 13th of February, 1861? This is going to be a guess. Peyton March, William Sherman, Colonel J.D. Irwin, or Tasker Bliss? One of these people got a Medal of Honor, the very first one, for their actions on the 13th of February, 1861. See if you can come up with it, okay? There you go. All right, with me. All right, good. Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. Thank you. Let's all do the American Pie. That'll get us through the show. Bye-bye, Miss American Pie. The Big Bopper, Jonas Kane, ladies and gentlemen. I'll put him down. He showed up. Jonas Kane is in the room. Everybody back up. Before he takes over with his positivity. You know where he needs to go? He needs to go to the White House, Jonas Kane. He needs to show everybody what's wrong.
Yes.
There you go. Put some positivity spin on it. I'm so tired of all the bad news. It is. All right, what we got? Guess Sherman? Okay. You can guess. It's all a guess. That's why I give you multiple choice. If I didn't give you, you wouldn't know who it was. All right? It's just not trivia. It's entertainment and informational. Gee. Nobody else wants a guess? All right, well, I'll tell you then. That's how I am. It was a Colonel J.D. Irwin. Colonel Irwin and a group of men went to the rescue of the U.S. 7th Infantry who were trapped by the Apaches. So there you go. That's the answer. There we go. Is that enough for history? I think. We did enough history. So close up the history. Put a lock on it. Put a lid on it. Put something on it. Jonas Kane.
I'm trying to help my nephew who's taking middle school online these days. I'm trying to explain to him that you always start on the ground floor. You start with the first thing, build off of that to the second, the third, and the fourth. But these kids these days, they're so impatient. What they want to do is just start right at the end and work their way back. I keep telling them that's not how life works.
Poof!
Yeah!
Jonas Kane. And it's time for a little teeny, teeny bit of cowboy history, cowboy trivia, because I've run out of trivia for the Cowboys. But that's okay. We don't care. We're happy just the way we are. Absolutely. So here we go. On September 26, 1879, what town burned to the ground? Sawmill owner John Hunter supplied enough lumber to rebuild nearly all of Main and Sherman streets. Was it Arlington, Deadwood, Butte, or Cheyenne? Which town burned to the ground on September 26, 1879? Was it Arlington, Deadwood, Butte, or Cheyenne? Let's see what we got here, all right? Oh, Robert Hale, I wish I was there. I saw all the stuff, all your tables and stuff set up. It looked like it was really nice, that Magic Estates sale. Very good. All right, what we got? All right. So we got Butte, and we got Deadwood. What else we got? Anything else? All right. Unbelievable. This is the big bopper. All right, a couple answers. Oh, Buttewood. How's it going, Ed? That's what a way to do it. Alright. So these are all guesses. It's a multiple choice. Alright? Either you get it or you don't. That's why it's trivia. Alright, what do we got? Anything? Hey, they're actually letting me see the show today. That's good. So I can see there's all eight people hanging around, milling around outside. It was Deadwood. Deadwood, South Dakota. The town burned down September 26, 1879, and they rebuilt it just like magic. In Tombstone's Arizona, brief heyday. In Tombstone, Arizona, brief heydays from 1878 to 1860. I'm looking at you trying to read it at the same time. Stop it. In Tombstone, Arizona's brief heydays from 1878 to 1886, how much silver was produced in dollars? All right, how much silver was produced in dollars in Tombstone, Arizona's heyday? Was it 20 million, 80 million, 50 million, or 40 million? See if you can come up with it, all right? I should rehearse. But no, I don't, Kielwood. All right, there you go. Better late than never. Joe's here, ladies and gentlemen. That's okay. I give him a point for showing up. You know, everybody else is here on time. Joe, next time, wear a watch. It doesn't matter. I don't care if he come in last minute. There you go. 20 million, 80 million, 50 million, or 40 million. All right. I gotta see who's, what's next in our crew here. Everyone last week, of course, we passed the savings on to the next human being. Hi-o Silva, 50 million, Ed says. Jonas says 40 million. We got enough answers? I think so. I'm happy with what I got. I figure. It was $80 million, and in silver was mined in the heyday of Tombstone, Arizona. Wow. Here we go. Put 60 seconds on the clock. Try to come up with the answer for our concentration puzzle. Here we go. All right, let's see what we got here, right? Facebook's gonna mess with me again. All right, let's see what we got here. Dan and Patty love these, I can just tell. They're over there in the corner taking all these pictures and trying to sort them out and figure out who it is. All right. Anybody else? Oh, good. Anybody else? Let's see. We'll get a couple more in here, maybe. All right. All right. I think you got it. I think you got it. Oh, there you go. I eat punks like you for breakfast. That was right. That was, what? Rich Gilbert Dunk. It was Broderick Crawford. I eat punks like you for breakfast. Yeah, Broderick Crawford. There you go. That's the weirdest thing because my grandmother did it. I don't know, but she did. I don't know. She said, you know, I once dated Broderick Crawford. I went, what? He's actually born, not born, but he is buried in Glover's in New York. That's just the weirdest thing. Broderick Crawford. Oh, my goodness. All right, another 60 seconds on the clock. See if you can figure out who this person is. If you do, good for you. Here we go. Hope you'll be able to figure it out. I think you will. All right. This is somebody, from history? You'll figure it out. You guys are smarter. You don't need me to help you. You don't need no stinking clues. All right, I had fun with these. These are a lot of fun for me. All right. Anybody else got an answer? Just go wait a few more seconds here. We got time. We got time. I don't care. Where am I going? I gotta be till 3 anyway. Oh, good. Rich, I don't know if that's an answer, but I'm gonna give you. I know, Michael Murth. There you go. Got everybody? I think so. Don Quixote. The O'Donnell. Good old Don Quixote. That's right. There you go. There you get the Don and the Q and the Odie. Oh, well, what are you going to do?
It's trivia time with Bob Carroll. It's trivia time for you. Thank you.
I'm with you. All right, there you go. All right, so here we go. This is mind-blowing trivia. All right, a new intro. Same stuff, new intro. Here we go. This colorful board game was invented as a distraction for children who were suffering from polio in the 1940s. Colorful board game that was invented as a distraction for children suffering from polio in the 1940s. See if you can come up with the right answer, okay? All right, see if you can, I'd appreciate it. There you go. Michael Cody Mirth. Cool. You're gonna change your name? Really? Ah, all right. Robert Hales. Here. Hi, Robert. How are you? Nice to see you. I was going to take a plane, come down to see you. What are you going to do? Twister, all right? some game board. Colorful one, too. Parcheesi. Michael Wald. Oh, he showed up finally. And you won. Nah, I just got here, for goodness sakes. All right? Okay. I didn't know there was 30 magicians in that area. I just thought it was just Jim Spinato land. There you go. I wish I was down there because I'd love to work that casino again. All right. I worked Foxwood, but not with him at the other place. All right. Michael Wald? Where is he? All right. There you go. Roulette. That's right. I don't think so, Mr. Michael Mirth. Coyote? What was it? It was Candyland. Candyland, that's right. That was the right answer. Candyland. The Candyland. There you go. That's what it was. Candyland. What animal? Not us. We're not animals. Well, some of us. What animal has the highest blood pressure? What animal has the highest blood pressure? I might have said this one months ago, but I don't remember, but could be. But what animal has the highest blood pressure? See if you can come up with the right answer. If you can, I appreciate it. Here we go. What animal has the highest blood pressure? Don't blame me for these. Well, don't blame Debbie either. She has nothing to do with it. I just put her name on. All right, what do we got? You think the mouse does? Yeah, I think so, because they're always looking around for the cat, trying to find a hole in the wall. I don't know. I don't know how they found this out, but we should be looking for a vaccine, but no, we got scientists telling me about high blood pressure. So chipmunk, a raccoon, a rat, an elephant. That's a cow. We got enough? I think so. It was a giraffe. A giraffe it was. Not a chipmunk. It wasn't a bipmunk either. It was a giraffe has the highest blood pressure. Wow. Hey, here's a good question. See, follow along. When these were first introduced into cars in the 1930s, there was a huge battle over whether they were too distracting or not. And some states contemplated heavy fines for those who used them. What were they in the 30s that caused such a battle? They were a distraction in cars. I'm thinking showgirls. Yeah, too much necking. That's right, the neck. High blood pressure. Because you don't see many short-necked giraffes around. Exactly. Makes sense. Giraffes. High blood pressure. Oh, jeez. Robert Hale just comes for questions. He's busy. He's a man on the go. He's always busy, but he's gotta put those tables and chairs away. Jonas. Oh my gosh. Hey, stop it, Rich. Whoop. whoopee cushions. Yeah, that could have been it, yeah. But brakes, rear view mirrors, and... All right, there you go. Rear view mirrors and brakes. Brakes, you put... That was a big distraction. It was toilets. Toilets was... It was a big distraction because you're driving around, somebody's using the toilet, and you'd go, what? No, that wasn't right. That wasn't right. It was, ladies and gentlemen, it was car radios. Car radios. Michael Wall, just squeeze that in there. There you go. There you go. Car radios. Wow, wasn't that fun? That was Debbie's mind-blowing trivia. Do you have one more? All right, I'll do this. What fast food sandwich? Listen to this one. What fast food sandwich debuted on Good Friday, 1962? What fast food sandwich debuted on Good Friday, 1962? I'll give you a hint. It was at McDonald's. There you go. You don't have to go through every fast food chain. What fast food sandwich premiered on Good Friday, 1962? Go! Your turn. I think toilets would have been the best answer for the 30s in the cars, wouldn't it? Everybody have a record player in the car? We had a record player. The records were upside down, and the needle was weighted. And when the record played, when it was done, it fell down into a tray. Every time you went over it, it would bounce. But we had one. It was crazy. Record player in a car. Goldfish tacos.
You got the rights for me, son.
Anybody else got an answer? I think so. Who's ahead today? Let's see. Nobody. Oh no, we got one person ahead. There's two people. Whose room am I in? All right, that's a good question. Let me look around. All I see is a green screen, but... No, you know... Let me look over here. You know whose desk that is? Can I go this way? Look at that. You know whose desk that is? You know where I am? Is there an ashtray there? There is. I don't think he smoked. No. Looks like a president's room. No, it wasn't. It was the entertainer, Mr. Wayne Newton, ladies and gentlemen. I'm in Wayne Newton's office. This is Wayne Newton's in his mansion. This is all his stuff, all his awards, and some of the things are up there on the thing. So yeah, they let me come in here. There you go. Filet of fish, and that's where it went, right down the crapper. You had a couple of filet, and they kept the bones in it for good measure. That was one of the things. Filet of fish. Wow, that was exciting. Thank you, Debbie, for showing us. Oh, that was cool. All right, what do we got now? You know what we'll do here? I know, here's, you know, what?
You're watching Bob Carroll's Trivia Time on Facebook.
I'm a spaceman. The moon and sun and all the stars are great big Tootsie Roll Pops.
I'm a princess.
Yes, my lord, it's a party tonight. We'll have Tootsie Roll Pops. All of the kids in the neighborhood say Tootsie Roll Pops are triple good. Triple good.
And do you know why? Sure, because one, there's good-tasting hard candy outside. And two, there's a delicious center of Tootsie Roll inside. And three, only Tootsie Roll Pops are such fun to eat. That's why they're triple good.
And don't forget, Tootsie Roll Pops come in a party pack, too. 10 pops in assorted flavors. There's a game on the back that's lots of fun to do. All of the kids in the neighborhood say Tootsie Roll Pops are triple good. Triple good.
You'll love Tootsie Roll Pops.
I love Tootsie Roll Pops. How many licks does it take to get to the center of a Tootsie Roll Pop? Oh boy. We're going to do TV trivia now. Oh, yeah. I don't know what that year was. It was in the 60s, because it was black and white, probably. That's right. All right, so we're going to do, the Addams Family. Oh, Addams Family Trivia. Addams Family Trivia. This will be fun. What former child star played Uncle Fester? Let's see if you come up with this one. I hope you can. What was it? Well, what child star was he? All right. Okay, thank you, Michael. I don't know. 63 could have been the 50s for all I know. I don't know. What former child star played Uncle Fester? Addams Family Trivia. Come on, you can't beat this. Snap your fingers, kids. Let's go. And go. Just a guess. Just a guess. Okay. Robert Hale, ladies and gentlemen. Patty! Shirley Temple. What? Thanks, Jonas. Says they're having, sorry, we're having trouble playing this video. I'm having trouble making this video. What is their problem? I'm doing all the work. All they gotta do is turn on the system. Reverend Jim. We got it? We got everybody? I think so. It was Jackie Coogan. Jackie Coogan was right. What did Morticia do that always got Gomez excited? If you know what I mean. What did Morticia do that always got Gomez excited? See if you can come up with the right answer. I think you can. You guys are smarter than a whip. Okay. Boy, you guys are unbelievable. I try to stump you with this stuff, but it's hard. It really is. And then he started kissing her. That's right. Kissed her hands. Ooh, Mike Sherry. All right. Hey, she didn't disrobe. Hey, stop it. Wee-wee. Wee-wee, Ed. There you go. Did the laundry. There you go. Did the laundry and then spoke French. There you go. There you go. Everybody knows it was spoke French. Wee-wee-wee, as I say on my little translating machine on my phone. Wee-wee. Wee-wee. Took French for 4 years. I was just in love with that teacher. Levez-vous, tevez-vous, and donnez-moi les papiers. Sit down, shut up, and hand in your papers. Sorry. Who played Lurch? That's all I learned in French. Who played Lurch? What was his name? The guy who played Lurch. This is easy today, isn't it? It's like easing back into things. Show 176. If anybody would like to make a magic video for my 200th video, make a video, send it to me through a website called WeTransfer, and I'll put it on for my 200th episode. And unless it's not good, then I won't even bother. But, all right, there we go. No, I will. I mean, I'm up for anything. It's not my show. It's your show. I'm just a conduit. I'm just... What? A conduit? What does that mean? All right. Jeez, Robert Hale. Come on, stop it. Tom Gentile. Dick Cheney. What was that? Played Lurch. Oh, my gosh. And Dan and Patty. Patty? I think Patty's the brains behind the outfits. I really think so. Unless Dan's out there snoring. I don't know what he's doing. Keeps posting things on a thing. He says, what is this, and do you have the instructions for it? I wish I had instructions for you. I had a guy once who was going to give me thousands of pages for instructions, but then I said, what am I going to do with them? Wish I'd have kept them, but it didn't happen. But what are you going to do? Ted Cassidy, and that's the second question. Rich, I'm going to give you a point. I'm going to give you a point for that just because you're so close to the real answer. What did they pull when they called for the butler? What did they call the butler with? What did they pull to get the butler? See if you can answer that question. If you get it, then he come and he say, you rang, all right? And there you go. What did they call the butler with? They reached up and what did they do? Oh, Jill is helping today. Well, Jill, thank you, Jill. We appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you for helping Robert Hale today. We appreciate any help he can get. Well, I'm surprised I still have viewers. All right. That's where. Thank you, Jill, for helping out. Oh, it's one extra viewer. I didn't know this. All right. That's right. You are absolutely right on that answer. Oh, well, I'll give it to you anyway. It's not quite the right thing, Tom, but... Joe? And Dan? Yeah. But I guess what they wanted, well, what I wanted, but I'll give it to you all anyway. It was a noose. It was Uncle Tanoose. They pulled on Uncle Tanoose, and no, that's not right. That's just nasty. All right. Anybody know this? What famous ex-witch played Morticia's mother? What famous ex-witch played Morticia's mother? See if you can come up with the right answer. If you can, it would be a lot of fun if you knew the answer. Let's go. What famous ex-witch? I don't know how you get to be an ex-witch, but yes, played Morticia's mother. All right. See if you can come up with this one. Yes, Uncle Tanoose. Yes. All right. Uncle Tanoose. All right. What famous ex-witch played Morticia's mother? Robert Hale and Jill will know this. I think Jill knows this. Let's find out. Oh, let's see. Wow. Anybody get it right? Some people got it right. One person. Oh, Samantha Stevens. And I think we got everybody's answer. I'm pretty sure it was Ed Gardner got that one right. That's right. It was, believe it or not, Margaret Hamilton from The Wicked Witch of the West, whatever. From The Wizard of Oz. That was the right answer. Unbelievable. All right. You got it? I'll just save the rest of them for later. We're running late. That's what everybody's saying. I think people are going, hey, Bob, spin it up. We want to see some other stuff. There you go. Unbelievable.
You're watching Bob Carroll's Trivia Time on Facebook.
All right, so here we go. We're going to play a commercial. It's the young lady in the ad that you're looking for. She grew up to be an actress. Who is this person?
Uncle Tim, I'm making dinner. Want to stay?
What are you having?
Pork chops.
Just pork chops?
Pork chops with potatoes or stovetop stuffing for pork.
Stuffing? I'm staying.
Stovetop stuffing made specially for pork. It makes it a meal worth staying for.
Wow, this stovetop tastes great with pork.
Stovetop made it to go with pork.
Great combination.
Stovetop stuffing for pork. Look for the green box.
There you go. So all you gotta do is come up with something, see what you can come up with. Hope you get it. So here we go. Who was that lady, that young girl, who grew up to be in a couple movies, as a matter of fact. All right? see if anybody gets it. I don't blame you if you don't, because I had to look three times, and I said, oh, I got it. But maybe you'll get it, maybe you won't. We'll see. The old Radnor. Ah, good guess, good guess. All right. And what else we got here? I liked, this was, Debbie and I, we went to the Wayne Newton's mansion when they had a, it was really nice, really nice. So I said, I'll put this up. You know, his office is there. He lives out in Montana now. And he does a show, used to do a show all the time, but out there at the Bally's, I think. Lily Tomlin, all right. Just waiting for Robert Hale to check in. He's checking with Jill now to see what's going on. All right. Anybody else? Boy, this time went by, didn't it? This hour on national TV, on Facebook? Unbelievable. Gary. All right. There you go. I think we got enough answers. Let me just see what's going on here. All right, we got it? I think so. It was Ally Sheedy. Ally Sheedy. Well, I think she was in Short Circuit, wasn't she? I think so. There you go. All right, well, that was a little bit of commercial trivia. I'm so excited.
Jeffrey Allen here from the American Museum of Magic. Where is the museum?
Right behind you. Just turn around, Jeffrey. There we go. So all you got to do is come up with the right answer. Where is that place? Thought he could see it. He was standing right in front of the darn thing. Wow. Right, Gary? What? No. Oh, I get you. Dan and Patty. All right. Oh, look at Jonas. Look at him go. Wow, crazy. And Joe. Gilbert. Colonel Mustard. And Tom got one. There you go. Marshall, Michigan is exciting, isn't it? That was Magic Minutes. Let's see, we did a commercial, didn't we? All right, let's just do this. Are you ready? Okay. Puzzle. This is from Rich, so he can't guess. So Rich does not have to guess for this one, unless he doesn't remember it. But this is from Rich, a word puzzle. Go with the 60 seconds on the clock. See if somebody gets this. I hope you do. Good luck, everybody. Thanks for coming in today. We appreciate it. Don't forget to make some pizza salad. Thanks. thank you, Rich. Don't guess. When you get the answer right, you won't guess. You might not be the only one that's not guessing. We'll see. See, they're tougher than you think, aren't they, Rich? Not even a whisper of a guess. I've lost all my viewers because of this, Rich. Shame on you. We're getting there. Spanish steak. Let the steak rest. You're so close, guys. You're so close. See, I know if I give you enough time. All right, you got it? I think so. Everybody got it? All right, there you go. It's a cut above the rest. A cut above the rest. Yeah, I know. That should have got a boo. A cut above the rest. Robert Hale just swings it in there just at the last minute. There you go. Joe's answer, yes, it is right. It is a cut above the rest. I didn't think anybody would get that, but, you know, you keep something there for about 3 days. Somebody's going to come up with the right answer. Michael Mirth got it right. He was working on it right there. All right, here we go with the next puzzle. All right, let's go. Let's see if you can figure it out. I hope you do. There. Let's go. All right. 60 seconds on the clock. Let's go. A cut above the rest. That was a good one. Thank you, Rich. We appreciate it. My pencil's working overtime, Dave. Got it? I think so. And Jonas. And Ed Gardner. There you go. You got it right. That was absolutely right. It was 16 candles. That's right. That was great. That was word puzzles. Boy, what a day we've had, huh? It's been really exciting. I appreciate everybody coming in today. And thank you. I know you're busy people, and I know you got other things to do with your lives. And, you know, we're just trying to stay social distance. We just go to the store and come back. You know, we're not going to the movies. Well, who is? But, you know, we're not going out and anything. But we're just happy. We're just have to still be here. So that's what we're going to be doing, just still be hanging around. And I'm glad everybody showed up today. So it is that time. It's time now for...
What the heck?
All right, let's see what the heck is going on. Unless your guess is as good as mine, but yeah, there it is. There's, what the heck were you thinking? Do I have to really even say anything? I mean, seriously, is that going to even work? I just want to be there when they try to change that tire. That's all I want to do. And also, yep, the C's are, they're just standing outside the White House, just getting ready to be called in. That's exactly right. All right, there you go. Come on, guys, go on in. I think it's your turn. And finally, Shane, stop putting stoner-approved seals on the fried chicken. The manager.
What the heck?
Winner! Winner!
Yabba-dabba-doo!
Another lucky.
lucky winner.
I don't need no stinking points.
You can't handle the truth.
You are the weakest link. Goodbye.
Join Bob Carroll next time for more trivia on Facebook.
So what do you want me to do, drop my pants and fire a rocket?
Go ahead. Make my day.
Go to the coast. We get together, have a few laughs.
To boldly go where no man has gone before.
Wow, is that it? Is it my time is up? I can't believe it. You know, I was over here counting up points to see who was here and who wasn't here, and I guess I found out the right people, didn't I? Hey, what am I going to do? There you go. Push the button. There we go. We got it? We got it. It's unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. Who's our lucky winner today? It was Gary Levinson. Gary Levinson, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, my gosh. Gary Levinson, thank you very much. Appreciate it. Who's here today? Well, it was Dan and Patty. Thank you, Dan and Patty, for coming in today. Rich and Tom and Ed and Jonas. Tomorrow, Terry Morgan said he'd be back. Kind of busy today. Gary Levinson, Michael Wald. He's in and out like a shot. Mike Mirth and Robert Hale, ladies and gentlemen. Everybody was here, and I appreciate it. Remember to mask it up, and more important than that, social distance. You know, so if you're going to dine, eat outside. We're waiting for the Olive Garden to have those buy one, get one frees. We'll have dinner for a month. There you go. Unbelievable. Had a great time. Oh, yes, I did. All right. Well, there you go. It's nice to be important, but it's more important to be nice, everybody. Absolutely crazy. Is it my turn? I think so. Thank you. Until we see you again, my friends. Remember, wear a bra. Don't smoke. Have a mint once in a while. Deodorant under the arms. What for? You're not going to be close to people. You're 6 feet away. I got to go. Thanks, everybody. Bye-bye. Hit it. I forgot the music. There we go. Was it going to stay? He's running late. Thanks a lot, everybody. Have a real good day. Hope to see you again real soon. Bye-bye, everybody. Whoa! Show is pre-recorded in front of a live audience.
Welcome back now. Here.